Hey there, I'm Dr. Dave. Today I'm going to go ahead and give you a really simple meditation that's going to help you through depression and anxiety and a lot more. And you can do this in your home, you can do this in your office, your car, not while you're driving, but do it in a place that's convenient and comfortable for you. I'm going to keep it fairly short, but it's going to be really effective at meditating to combat mental health issues, especially depression and anxiety. I'm not going to go into anything else today on this episode. I'm going to keep it clean after this break, only the meditation. But keep in mind, if you're brand new to me and if you want to know more, I do a podcast here on microdosing psilocybin for mental health and a lot more. So make sure you subscribe, join me. I've got a lot going on. So check it all out, especially the show notes. Okay, I'll see you on the other side. We'll start the meditation right away.
Enter the world of magic mushrooms with Microdose U.
Okay, so today we're going to go on a hike. We're going to go on a hike near my home, Salt Lake City, Utah. It's called the Living Room, and it's a really nice hike. And during this hike, when you and I hike together, we're going to talk, and we're going to talk through some issues. We're going to talk through how to feel better every single day. The good news is you could just be sitting on your sofa or laying in your bed or, in your office or wherever you might want to be, someplace very comfortable. I suggest you should be someplace very comfortable. Lay back, kick back, close your eyes, and let's hike together. So right now it's a little bit of a hot day. It's approaching 92 degrees out. And we're going to hike up to the living room, which is a really cool hike here in Salt Lake City. And so let's make sure you have the right shoes on. Let's make sure you get some hiking poles. And let's just start off really, really slowly, because it's going to be about a mile and a half uphill. And then we're going to come down together. So I'll just take it. Let's take our time. Make sure you have plenty of water with you here. And as we start to hike, we just feel the connection with the earth. And we feel that our feet are firmly planted on the earth. One foot is just simply going in front of the other, and we're starting to walk very slowly uphill. And as we hike together, let's just keep things really positive. I want you to think about your life and about all the things that you have actually good going on. Now, you might have some bad, but let's focus on the good things today, because we're going to really make this a super positive hike. And we just passed two people coming down, and they gave us a really wonderful smile, and we just smiled back at them. And that just kind of increased our endorphins a little bit, because whenever you connect with another human being, especially on a hiking trail, it just feels really good. So I'm going to say to you, as we hike together, let's make sure to make eye contact and say hello to people. Just smile. It doesn't have to be a conversation, but just say hello and smile. And if we have to move out of the way, or if they move over for us, let's just make sure, again, we smile and say thank you very much when appropriate. So let's continue up our hike. It's definitely hot out here. It's warm, but all we have to do is put one foot in front of the other and just keep walking at pace that's good for us. We don't have to go too fast. And that also is true when we're thinking about helping ourselves through depression and anxiety. We don't have to do everything at once. So many people want to jump into a protocol and a routine where they're doing everything at once. And that usually doesn't work, because too much too fast just doesn't work. So let's just take it slow today. I'm just going to, again, doesn't matter if you're in good shape, in bad shape, you can put one foot in front of the other, right? Let's just do that on a very, very slow pace. And we're going to make this work out. It's going to happen. Okay, now be careful, because these rocks that we're, stepping over are, they can be treacherous, because if you take the wrong step, you could slip. And even though we're not high up, you could slip and you could fall. You can break an ankle. You can sprain something. You can get cut very badly. So let's make sure we look out for all of these rocks and just be very careful as we step on them and over them. And it's also a metaphor for our lives, because as we're stepping over these rocks, that could symbolize we're dealing with things in life that could be a little bit difficult if we're not careful. But if we just take our time and step carefully, it generally works out. And what happens if we go too quickly and step on the wrong rock or slip on the rock? That's right. We're going to fall down. And even if we fall, we can get up and get better and resume. Or sometimes we take a step back, because stepping on a rock and falling could be symbolizing a bad relationship or a bad business decision. We all make mistakes and we step on those rocks and we slip. But slipping on a rock is never permanent. Sure, we might have to rest for a while. We might have to, again, take a step back, but it's not permanent. We can always regroup and continue on the journey to feeling better every single day. Oh, we just moved over off the trail for some hikers that were coming down, two women coming down the trail. We just moved over for them. And I'm surprised, you know, usually people say thank you when you move off the trail, get out of their way and allow them to come by. But these two women were caught up in their world, not noticing anything else around them. And they didn't even have the courtesy to say, thank you for moving over and allowing us to come through. Thank you. So what does that tell us? Well, first of all, every person you encounter on the trail and in life is not going to necessarily resonate with you. Some people are just caught up in their own stuff, their own world, and they don't even have a second or even the common courtesy to acknowledge or say hello or say thank you. But no matter what we try to do and how positive we are and the energy that we exude along this trail today, that doesn't mean everybody else is going to fit into our energy. And it's really interesting, as we continue this hike along the trail, we can just look at somebody and notice if they have positive energy that is exuding from them, and positive energy is contagious, or we can tell if they have more negative energy. And unfortunately, negative energy is contagious as well. So what we're going to do is we're going to try to stay away from the people on this trail today that have the negative energy. That doesn't mean we're going to bump into them or push them over the side or anything like that, but we're just going to say hello and continue to move on. Whereas sometimes on the trail, if you come across somebody with real positive energy, they throw you a compliment. It's very common that I get compliments because people say, I love your hat, or they smile. And it's okay to stop and chat for a few minutes and take a little break and you know, find out what other positive people are doing in their lives. There's nothing wrong with that. Because the more positivity you have in your life and surrounding you, even if it's for a brief moment, somebody that you meet in line somewhere, somebody that you meet on a trail, and you love their smile, tell them that. I know these days we're always afraid to say things because, you know, we have to worry whether things are politically correct and if you're going to offend somebody. But I don't think telling somebody that they have a beautiful smile or that you like their hat or something like that, or even like you seem like you're a really good hiker, you must hike a lot because you really know what you're doing. Those kind of things, they're positive energy. And the more positive thoughts we can think about, and the more positive compliments we can give out during the day, it's really interesting, but I swear to you, the depression and anxiety, they do start to melt away. So remember, even after we leave this trail shortly, when you encounter other people, don't look the other way. Even if just like a head nod or a smile, it goes a long way. And when you keep having this positivity every day, all day, I promise you, things start to change in your life. It won't happen overnight. No, you won't be doing this hike with me and then tomorrow morning, you're all of a sudden feeling better and everything's perfect. No, that's not going to happen. But if you listen to this meditation once a week, even, or a few times a week, and you really take it seriously and you incorporate the little ideas and symbols that we talk about here on this hike into your life, you will start to feel better. This 100% works. 100%. Now we're getting close to the top and we're sweating. It's difficult. We've been drinking our water, staying hydrated, staying safe, being very careful with every step. And we're almost at the top now. So when we get to the top, we're going to take a little break. We're going to take some pictures of the beautiful landscape and the beautiful view from the top. And we're going to think about this beautiful day and looking down on the Great Salt Lake and Salt Lake City from this beautiful vantage point above. We can just see things and start to think about the beauty wherever we are. So go ahead, let's take a few pictures, and let's take a few pictures of each other, and we can keep these in our albums and on our phone and always think about this hike that we're doing today. And now we're going to start down. Downhill, a lot of people think, is easier than uphill. Like, all I have to do is walk downhill and it's so easy. That's not necessarily true. Walking downhill, hiking downhill, can actually be sometimes more treacherous because I think it's much easier to trip on the downhill. So what does that mean to you? Think about that for a second. It appears easy. It appears easier, but it's actually much easier to stumble and fall. I want you to think about that one for just a moment or so. Think about what that means. When it seems easy, sometimes it's more common to stumble and fall and maybe even hurt yourself. Think about it. I mean, I'm sure you've heard the expression, when things seem like they're so good and so easy, then there's oftentimes danger nearby. So always be careful. Always be alert. Be positive, but always be alert, because I don't want to see you get into something that's difficult for you just because it seemed easy. Be very careful. I'm really enjoying hiking with you today. We should really do this more often. And you're pretty darn good at hiking, I can tell. You're confident now. On this downhill, you seem a lot more relaxed now than you were with me on the uphill. On the uphill, you were a little bit tentative, not sure what to expect. But now that we've gotten to the toughest part, the top, and then now we're heading down, other than being careful that we don't stumble, you're doing really well. I want to congratulate you, because I think on some level, just from hiking with me today, you're feeling a little bit better. Do you feel it? And again, I'm not saying after one hike with me together, I'm not saying that you're going to be cured of everything. No, it doesn't. Things don't work that way. Just think how long it took for you to get depressed or anxious or whatever you're going through. Just fill in the blank. Think how it doesn't happen overnight. It's something that just happens little by little over a long period of time. And then all of a sudden, you realize that something's not right. So as we finish this hike today, you should feel more positive for sure. But it's not the end. It's not the cure. We're not finished. We have a lot of work to do together. And if you like this, let me know and I can do more hikes with you or more activities or in way of a meditation for sure. I would love to. But as we finish this hike, I want you to drink water, hydrate. The water is like the, you know, our bodies are what, I don't know, what I can't remember, 80 to 90% water, something like that, 90 some percent water, I don't remember exactly, but it's life. It's like, although water is not living itself, it's crucial for life. So I want you to drink plenty of water today after this hike. And I want you to think about what we did and what we talked about and how your life is going to get better right now, one step at a time. Okay, let me know how you like this hike and how, if you want future meditations, and even if you have ideas where we can go together and meditate just like this. I'll see you in the next episode. I'm Dr. Dave. This is Microdose U.